Who's your team?
Some old comrades.
With the new Captain Price coming in Call of Duty Modern Warfare, saying that at the very end of the reveal trailer, we can, we can all but confirm that Soap is going to be coming back in the new Call of Duty title. Probably Ghost and probably a lot of other fan favorites. And I thought it would be cool to go back in time a little bit. So I have a video for you guys that I put up about 3 years ago. And this is the truth about Soap, about John Soap McTavish. Because I see people on my Twitter timeline that they don't know the story. They don't know the Modern Warfare story and how big of a part this man played throughout the trilogy. So hopefully you guys enjoy a little flash from the past. If you do, drop a like. And if you guys would like to see the Ghost Riley story again, let me know. Enjoy. What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to the Truth Series. This is the series on my channel where we go a little more in depth, a little more in detail into certain things. And a while back, I did the truth about Simon Ghost Riley, and a lot of people enjoyed it, and a lot of people asked me if I would do other Call of Duty heroes like Soap or Captain Price, and the answer is yes. Today, we are going to go over the truth about John Soap McTavish, one of the most revered Call of Duty heroes in the Call of Duty universe, and I know a lot of you found an attachment to him throughout the Modern Warfare series, just like I did. So sit back for a couple minutes, drop a like if you guys would like to see some more Call of Duty Hero Truth series, maybe Captain Price, I don't know. Leave me a comment what your best memory of Soap is, and away we go. This month's giveaway is for a brand new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, turn on those notifications, and tweet me why you want to win it with your Twitter handle included. John Soap McTavish is the main protagonist of the Modern Warfare trilogy and the primary playable character throughout most of the campaigns. Not much is known about Soap's early life other than the fact that he was raised Roman Catholic and that he was born in Scotland, which is discovered from his accent and the Scottish flags on his dog tags. But aside from that, not much else has ever been revealed about his past, which was possibly done on purpose to allow the player to get more attached to him, the same way that Master Chief's backstory in Halo is left very open-ended and up for interpretation. And we did a Master Chief Truth video as well if you guys want to check it out. There'll be a playlist in the description below. So the first time we meet Soap is in Call of Duty 4. He served as a sergeant and a special forces soldier. You actually get to play as Soap throughout most of the campaign, save for a handful of missions where you play as other soldiers. Soap's journey through the first Modern Warfare is, it's amazing. I mean, it really is. It's a lot of fun as he serves under Price during the ultra-nationalist crisis. Soap played a pivotal part in the first chapter of the Modern Warfare series, as near the end of the campaign, your squad chases after Zakif following a nuclear launch, and Soap is blown out of the Jeep and severely injured by an exploding fuel truck as Zakif slowly walks down the bridge, killing your squad mates one by one. But as he's distracted by an explosion in the distance, Price slides a pistol to Soap, which we will talk about later as well, which the player, you, Soap, uses to take out Zakif for being placed on a stretcher and passing out. And it's at that moment that we really get our attachment to Soap, but it's just beginning. His next appearance was in Modern Warfare 2, in which he served as a captain. He got promoted and a field commander of the Task Force 141 alongside Captain Price with Roach and Ghost under his command. This may be the single Call of Duty title with the most attachable heroes we've ever seen. Price, Roach, Ghost, and Soap all together. And there is also, fun fact for you guys, a point on the mission contingency in Modern Warfare 2 where he references hating dogs.
Frag grenades, one German Shepherd. Dogs, I hate dogs.
As he was always attacked by dogs in the Call of Duty 4 campaign, and a lot of people believe it's paying homage to Indiana Jones and his famous quote, I hate snakes.
Big snake in the plane, Jack! Oh, that's just my pet snake, Reggie! I hate snakes, Jack! I hate them!
So back on track. For most of the campaign, Soap is played by the computer until the end of the story, where the player takes control of him with Price at his side as you go to kill Shepard. And you get to throw the knife that goes through Shepard's face and it's one of the most incredibly satisfying boss scenes I've ever played in a video game. And there's two other facts about this game that not everybody knows. When you are playing in the mission Cliffhanger, if you don't move out of the way and let Soap scale the mountain, he will push you off as you are playing as the player Roach, and you will fall to your death. So Soap can actually kill you, and Soap can actually die in Modern Warfare 2 on the same mission, Cliffhanger. If you don't choose option B while you're playing as Roach, he will get shot and killed. Now we move forward to his third and final campaign appearance in Modern Warfare 3, in which he was again the captain and the field commander of Task Force 141. He is playable in the first mission of the game, but is played by the computer for the remainder of the campaign. This is also the campaign where Soap was killed in action, which we will get into in a minute. While he was on a mission to assassinate Makarov, the team breached the Hotel Lustig, and Makarov set up bombs, blowing Soap out of the building. He did, however, being the badass that he is, survive that fall, but he was seriously injured by the impact and the debris that fell on him after the detonation. He was rushed to the safe house, where he relayed information he attained on his last mission to Price before passing away. And the reaction from Price with this death scene is, to me, even though it's a video game, nothing short of heartbreaking. And one of the cool things about the Modern Warfare series is how everything comes full circle. If you guys remember, when Soap rescued Price from Gulag in Modern Warfare 2, he gave him his pistol back. And then, at the end, when Soap passes away, Price gives him that pistol back in return and leaves it on his chest, just symbolizing that their friendship had come full circle and everything has a means to an end. And Soap's accomplishments did not go unnoticed. In the cutscene for Stronghold, you'll see Soap had received the three highest decorations available to the British Commonwealth military personnel during his career, in the order of rank: the Victoria Cross, the Gallantry Cross, and the Distinguished Service Order. Once again, just showing how well he served his country and his brothers in arms. Even though Soap passed away in Modern Warfare 3, his memory lived on in multiple aspects throughout Call of Duty. He was actually playable in the Call of Duty Online title, as well in Ghost through a DLC add-on called the Soap Legend Pact. And there was also a conspiracy theory that he was hidden in the core game of Ghost, as on the IMBD website, it shows that Dan Glenn as John Soap McTavish's voice, and it says uncredited. Yet, even with the Soap Legend Pact, which was a DLC added later, I don't think you ever heard Soap's voice. So I'm not really sure why he was labeled in there for a voiceover when he was actually never in the Call of Duty Ghost core game. But a lot of people have taken that and ran and said that he was hidden in there somehow. Nobody has just been able to unlock him. It's safe to say that Soap will go down in COD history as one of the most iconic characters of the franchise alongside Captain Price and Ghost. He also lives on in the current title, Infinite Warfare, with the classic UMP-45, which is named after him, the MacTav-45. And a lot of people have said that they found his real-life counterpart. He was identified to look very similar to Johnny Mesner, who is an actor that played in the movie Tears of Sun, to the point where a lot of websites have said this is Soap's likeness in the real world. And there you have it, a quick journey through the life of John Soap McTavish. Maybe you learned something new. If you enjoyed it and want to see another Truth video in the future, drop a like on the video, check out the playlist below of all the previous Truth videos.
There's a clock tower in Hereford where the names of the dead are inscribed. We try to honor their deeds, even as their faces fade from our memory. Those memories are all that's left when the bastards have taken everything else.
What happened?
He killed Soap. He's gone, Mac.
What do you need from me, son?
A location. Our Russian says Makarov used to cache weapons at an old castle near Prague. He's got nothing more solid than that.
Can you trust him?
What choice do I have? He's got his own reasons for wanting Makarov dead. Place ring any bells?
Aye. We ran drones over a suspect castle back in Zakiev's day, but we never got wind of our targets visiting the area.
What am I up against?
The place is a fortress. Only one way in or out. Unless you've learned to fly. Security office on the far side of the compound, and a command center north of that. Both were heavily guarded. If Makarov's there, he'll be in that control room. What's this you're sending me?
Equipment list.
That's a lot of hardware, John. What you plan on doing?
what you taught me to do. Kill them all.